Okay, I think that should be perfect.
Let's get started.
Hello guys, this is Davud Akonzadeh here. Welcome to the another video about Prague, Czech Republic. I've been living here for the last 8 years, which been amazing experience of my life. I really enjoy making videos about Prague and sharing my experiences, things I like, things I don't like, or what are the things actually you don't supposed to do when you're in Prague, when you're visiting, or if you're already living here, you might be learning and you might change your behaviors in the end. That's why I decided to make this video, 5 things you need to know or you don't supposed to do when you're in Prague in Czech Republic. In this channel, I share my traveling experiences mostly. I also make summary videos like this one. So if you are new in this channel, make sure you subscribe for the future content. If you are guys also ready, let's get started. Street taxis are coming on top of my list of 5 things you don't have to do in Prague. Street taxis are super famous in Czech Republic. They've been multiple times in the news and it's one of the biggest issues in tourism industry in Czech Republic, specifically about Prague, because most of the tourists are coming and visiting Prague in Czech Republic. They've been quite famous for charging unbelievable amount of money to the tourists and scamming them. You can imagine even Prague mayor being undercover in the taxi. He pretended being tourist and took a taxi from the airport to the city center close to the castle, and he has been charged 500% more than he's supposed to be charged. So if you choose to take a street taxi or airport taxi from the airport, then there is a high possibility that you will be cheated, and this is one of the easiest ways how to get scammed in Prague in Czech Republic. Of course, there's a great possibilities and alternatives in Prague when you arrive to the airport or to the main station in Prague. There are multiple options. Either you can use public transport. Public transport is great in Prague. You can get a bus to the metro station from the airport and easily you can be anywhere in the city center. And as an alternative might be ordering taxi from the applications like Bolt. I believe it used to be Taxify. And also Uber is super famous for taking a ride easily, safely, and you will make sure that you get to your destination for fair amount of money. Based on my experience, I use Uber most of the time when I arrive to the airport, and it's super simple because when you order something from the Uber, then Uber application shows you exactly where you're supposed to stand at the airport, which exit you need to take, and obviously you know how much you will be charged and you know your driver, you know the car number, so in case anything happens you can easily report it. So make sure you don't use street taxi or airport taxi when you arrive to Prague. Use alternative options or simply just when you're in the city center walk, because Prague is small and it's easily reachable anywhere by foot. And the second thing you don't supposed to do in Prague when you are visiting or if you are already living here is using scooters. When you arrive to Prague and you see the scooters everywhere, and you might be thinking, okay, this is actually a really good idea to travel around Prague with the scooters. You can save energy, you can save time, and you can see most of the things around. But no, I will tell you the truth, guys. One of the easiest and the fastest ways to be hated by the local people is actually this way. You just use the scooter and you get so much hate on the street from the locals and expats living here. One of the reasons why people hate who using the scooters in Prague is actually about the sidewalks, because most of the time when people use it and then they leave it on the middle of the sidewalks, which is blocking the ways, then you can find them in a weird places actually where they've been parked. And also another reason is that the scooters make so much noise in the city center. You might not know or you haven't noticed it, most of the roads in Prague is actually from the small stones, and these scooters are not designed for Prague or a similar cities like Prague where the most of the roads are like rocks, small rocks. These scooters also doesn't have any amortization system, so that means they make so much noise in the streets. To be honest, I personally also don't like the scooters in Prague. I think Prague is amazing, it's a beautiful city, and this is the last thing probably the city needs. Prague is a small city, as I mentioned previously, and it's easy to reach anywhere by walk. So if you would like to see everything in Prague. You can take a walk from Václavské náměstí, where one of the main squares in Prague, in city center, and you can walk all the way to the Prague Castle just by walk. You don't need any transportation, and most importantly, you don't need the scooters. Number third from my list of five things you don't supposed to do in Prague is actually a bit interesting and a little bit funny as well. It's about elevators, and you don't supposed to ignore people when you get to elevator and when you are getting out of elevator. What do I mean by not ignoring people in the elevator? Actually, when you get into the elevator in Prague or in general in Czech Republic, you're supposed to say hi if there are people inside already. And when you are leaving the elevator, you're supposed to say goodbye when you are leaving and if there are still people. That's something I didn't know when I arrived to Prague, and that's something I never experienced in my country. So this was a very interesting experience, and that's something I learned and I apply right now whenever I go. Even I travel abroad from Czech Republic, I still do this. When I get to the elevator, if there are people already, I say them hi. And of course, when you are leaving, you have to say goodbye, even you don't know them. And you might be asking, okay, why am I supposed to say hi bye to the strangers if I don't know them? To be honest, I don't know. But this is the culture, this is the experience. That's something I learned here. That's why I'm sharing with you. So when you are arriving to Prague, that something is also applies to the small shops. You're supposed to say hi when you enter to the facilities where there are strangers, even you don't know them, or if you go to the doctor and you see there are people are sitting before you, you simply need to say hi to them. Also, for example, when I go to the small shop, which we call here potraviny, when I enter, even I don't see anybody, but I know that there's a cashier somewhere else, I still say hi. Even I don't get a response, that's fine. It's just a habit, kind of. As soon as I arrive and enter to the shop, I just say hi. And I think that's really interesting experience, and for sure I will be still keep doing it even if I don't live in Czech Republic or if I'm traveling somewhere else, just because I think it's nice, it's polite, and it's also breaking the ice, you know, this elevator silence, and it's nice way to interact with people. And number four from my list is don't miss eye contact when you are saying to cheers to strangers or to your friends, whenever you are having a drink in the restaurant, in the cafe, or wherever you are. If you are in Czech Republic, and that also applies to another European countries, actually, like Germany, so you don't supposed to miss the eye contact with people when you are saying cheers. And if you actually miss eye contact when you are saying cheers, that's something considered as impolite. And this is another habit I actually developed after I moved to Prague, to Czech Republic, and it was very interesting experience for me. So I started questioning, okay, why are we supposed to do that and what's standing behind this? I did a little bit of a research and understood that this is something coming from the history. In the past, it used to be common experience that people are getting murdered by the poison in their drinks. So in order to prevent that, when you are bumping the glasses to each other, this way your drinks are splashing from one to another. And this way, potential killer might be murdering himself or herself by splashing the glasses to each other, and the drinks might be mixing. This way, there's more risk the murderer or the potential killer might murder himself as well. Why I'm telling you this story? Because eye contact is also very connected to this tradition or historical reason. When you are bumping the glasses to each other, you should keep the eye contact with another person. This way, they made sure that there is no risk or there is no reason to look at the glasses or to look somewhere else. This way, opposite person might be more comfortable. So when you are in Prague, in Czech Republic, when you go for drinks with your friends, or if you are meeting some local people here, make sure you keep the eye contact when you are saying cheers to them. And finally, number five from my list is very connected to the first one. You don't supposed to take a street taxi, which applies same to to the don't change money on the street when you're in Prague in Czech Republic. And this is one of the easiest ways to get scammed and ruin your holidays here. When I say don't change money on street, probably it sounds very obvious for most of you, but there are still so many cases. People are scammed and they are just changing money on the street because they get better deals by strangers. These scammers, most of the time, they're just standing next to the exchange places. When people come to actually change money, they offer them better rates than exchange place. And people think, okay, I will be getting some extra cash if I don't change in this exchange place, but I can change it on the street. But the reality is that the money they will be giving you as exchange, it will not be Czech koronas, which is the main currency in Czech Republic, but they will be giving you some expired Belarusian rubles or whatever, which has no value at all. So basically you will be changing your euros, dollars for nothing. And you might be thinking, okay, in this case, exchange places are more safe. Answer to this question is actually no, they are not more safe. They also claim to have zero commission. However, most of the places actually offering so low rates, they get their commission from offering no commission at all. So you should be very careful. You should do your research before you arrive to Prague, and you have to find out where you will be staying and how much money you need to actually change and what are the best places to change money. And in general, if you are in city center in Prague, most of the places taking credit cards. In some cases, you don't even need to change money. And even you can pay for your public transport tickets in the ticket machines or in the trams. So this was the list of five things I put it together as you shouldn't be doing in Prague if you are visiting anytime soon, or if you are already living here, or if you have been in Prague. That's something I hope you found it very helpful. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.